So, my friends, you do know that I've been accused of being a pseudoscientist. And that is because I oppose physicalist views and try to explore the connection between science and spirituality. It's an obsession of mine. So, if that's the definition of being a pseudoscientist, then so be it. As you know, that one of my, or maybe you don't, that one of my popular books, or most popular books, has been The Seven Spiritual Laws of Success. And I've always wondered if scientists who read it would see any connections between my framework, which is totally consciousness-based and therefore spiritual, if any scientist would see parallels between what I'm saying in spiritual terms, would any scientist see parallels in terms of contemporary physics and quantum mechanics? So, guess what? Since I'm a fan of AI to dig out material from various sources and then correlate that and create new context and meaning, I went on AI, in this case Perplexity, and said, could you reframe Deepak Chopra's Seven Spiritual Laws of Success in terms of contemporary physics and quantum mechanics? And here's what I got in less than 60 seconds. Number one, the law of pure potentiality. In quantum mechanics, the concept of the wave function represents the state of pure potentiality where all possible outcomes coexist until measurement collapses the wave function into a definite state. Similarly, Chopra's idea of pure consciousness mirrors this field of infinite possibilities. I call this the field of infinite possibilities of experience, or the superposition of infinite possibilities of experience. Okay, number two, the law of giving. Quantum entanglement demonstrates interconnected particles influence each other instantly across distances. This parallels Chopra's notion that acts of giving and receiving create a flow of energy, emphasizing universal connectivity. Pretty good. Number three, the law of karma. The principle of cause and effect in classical physics is expanded in quantum mechanics to probabilistic outcomes. Similarly, Chopra's law suggests that every action generates a corresponding reaction, aligning with the probabilistic nature of quantum systems. Pretty good. Number four, the law of least effort. Quantum systems often seek states of least energy or equilibrium. For example, electrons occupying the lowest energy level. This reflects Chopra's idea that harmony and effortless action arise from alignment with natural laws. Number five, the law of intention and desire. In quantum mechanics, observation influences reality, the so-called observer effect. Chopra's law suggests that focused attention and intention can shape outcomes akin to how measurement determines a particle state. Six, the law of detachment. The uncertainty principle in quantum mechanics highlights the impossibility of predicting exact outcomes. Embracing uncertainty allows freedom and creativity. This aligns with Chopra's idea that detachment from results fosters abundance. Seven, the law of dharma. Quantum systems are governed by specific rules, quantization. Similarly, Chopra's law emphasizes living in alignment with one's unique purpose or quantized role within the universe. I actually call that role a distributed autonomous agent for the infinite. So you and I are distributed autonomous agents of the infinite being. Okay, so this concludes by saying this reframing connects Chopra's spiritual principles to fundamental concepts in quantum mechanics, highlighting parallels between metaphysical ideas and physical phenomena. So, what do you think, my friends? Do you find this interesting? Give me your feedback, and if you feel like it, share it with others. Take care. Live the seven spiritual laws. All this is theory.